Mitch Matthews, I believe this is your first time.
I think it's first time in studio.
Welcome.
I know we've talked a lot, but I think this is first time in here.
We're beginning a new era. Apparently, we didn't make you so mad that you wouldn't come in studio, so that's good, right? What's the biggest positive from the 20-point win over the weekend?
Just getting back on track, getting back with that positive mindset, getting that momentum back. You know, the October was tough. I think that was the first thing Coach Mendenhall said in the locker room was, man, I'm glad October is over. So, and we all are too. So that was a good way to end October. That was a good way to get back on track for November and start the bye week. I mean, I'm sure if we would have lost that game, bye week would have been a little more rough. But this week we're making sure resting up and getting healthy. But I think if we would have lost that game, it would have been a different story. So we're rolling.
I pointed out your T-shirt. I love it. It's the Intramural Championship T-shirt from this year. What'd you win?
Softball. Three years running.
Wow. So you have a dynasty going.
A dynasty, yeah. It started with me. My brother, Skylar Ridley, and Kurt Henderson first year. And then since they've left, it's just been me and Kurt. And then now, last year, I think I was the only one left. And I'm keeping it going.
Well, then.
You're hoping to get four years. Yeah, hoping
then
to get four.
Then there really is something to this Halloween costume scenario that you had.
The Sandlot picture.
Okay, you're Benny the Jet, man.
It was a lot of fun. So I was supposed to just be him by myself. That was my Halloween costume. And then my roommates wanted to join in. And then it ended up being, you know, we have guys that look like the guys. We have the right clothes. And so we ended up finding Riker to be the catcher. We ended up finding some of my good buddies. And even the right skin tone for most of the guys and the size and the hat. I mean, everyone had the right hats, the bats, and everything was perfect, so it worked out nice.
We tweeted that out.
Look at that thing. That was unreal.
That was awesome.
That was perfect.
I mean, you should have seen it on the pregame show.
So we were actually on the softball field, and we wanted it perfect. How many pictures did you take? We probably took. I mean, I had a girl take it with a really nice camera, so it looked as best as possible. And we even got the foot placement right. I mean, we picked it apart. Just so you'd be perfect with it.
It was beautiful.
It's hard to beat that, man. So good luck in the future. I think that's the pinnacle moment for Halloween.
Yeah, I don't think it'll be beat.
We can discuss some of the women's soccer costumes, but off air.
We can't talk about
some of those on air. I thought the win was so needed in so many ways. Take us into the locker room and And Middle Tennessee is not Boise State, but it's a win. You go on the road and you win. What was the locker room like after?
I want to say it was a sigh of relief, but it was more of a, like I said, it was more of a, we're back on track. We're back to who we are. We're back to, we can't, no more blaming anyone else. We're back to, you know, being ourselves. And I think we know how to win. We really do. And we had a streak there in October where it was, do we really know how to win? And I think that game really brought us back on track and pushed everything aside that was negative. I think positive moving forward, and we're happy. I mean, yeah, a win's a win, no matter what they say about the opponent. A win's a win, and it was a good win. And they played us really hard the first half, and second half we were diligent and made sure that we were impressive.
What was the message from your coaches after four straight losses leading up to Middle Tennessee? How did they motivate you guys?
That's a good question. I really am a big believer in players motivate and coaches coach. So as much as the coaches try to motivate and yell and scream, it almost makes it worse sometimes. And it makes it harder and it makes them more negative. And we all know that they want to win and they're there to help. But I think the motivation starts with your players and your leaders on the team. The guys who've been there, the guys who've gone through losses, those guys motivate you. And that comes from leadership and seniors. And this week was a big time to step up.
So at halftime, what's the conversation like? Because it's 7-7 at that point.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of those things where we knew the defense was playing great, playing out of their minds, and it was time for the offense to step up. And I have complete faith in Christian Stewart and all that he does, and so I don't think there was any worry. And we knew our stuff worked, and we're a great second-half team, and I think we came out and did what we knew we were going to do the whole game, and it finally cracked the second half, and so we're excited it did.
ESPN's Trevor Maddich, we just talked to him live, and he called Christian Stewart's performance after the Taysom Hill goes down over the last four starts marginally heroic. He's like, I don't want to oversell it, but I don't want to undersell it either. How would you sum up Christian's performance, 12 touchdowns, couple of interceptions, as he's been the starter?
I am impressed, and everyone in the country is impressed with him, whoever's seen him, and I sure hope BYU Nation's impressed with him, because as receivers, we surely are. And we know Christian Stewart is one of those guys that, man, no one expected Taysom to go down, but we knew the second that he came in that we weren't going to have to worry anymore. And he can throw the ball like crazy, and he can throw on the run. He can do a lot of things, and we're the best backup in the country, and now he's our starter, so we'll take him. And done a great job, and you know, I don't know if there's a name for him, but he's just done a great job, and we're proud of everything he's done.
BY Stu? No.
BY Stu. I like it.
That's good. Kristen Stewart. People are like, wait, the Twilight actor?
No,
like,
no, he's no, 70 no, million on, times better.
Come on. Yeah, exactly. Vampire! When you look at the receiving core, a guy that's emerged out of nothing, Colby Pearson.
Yeah.
Back-to-back games with 30-plus yard TDs. Tell us about who is Colby Pearson?
A great athlete. He's a guy, I mean, he's a walk-on that has a chip on his shoulder. He really is. And so he came in, and I was actually his big brother last year, and I got to know him really well. And he's a guy that you really can't get under his skin, you know, however much it is hard for the freshmen to come in and to play right away, because the coaches make sure that the freshmen know that they are freshmen. And so for him, it never got to him. And so this year coming in, it's his sophomore year, he did not let any coach get under his skin, and he plays with a chip on his shoulder, and I'm sure he's going to be an asset for us in the upcoming years and upcoming games, because he's proven himself and he doesn't get scared.
What do you want to accomplish the rest of 2014? Where do you want to leave BYU football after this season is over?
You know, everyone would say, you know, let's win the rest of the games, but that's, I mean, in my mind, that's, you want to be 1-0 after every single game.
Sure.
And but we want to play to the best of our ability, and when we do that, it's hard to beat us. So confidently, I can say when we play the best of our ability, it's really tough for anyone to beat us. And so playing at our best is all we can ask for. We don't want to talk about winning out or winning the rest of the games, because we get ahead of ourselves. So I think it just comes down to playing as hard as we can to be our best selves. And I think that's really hard to beat. And with Christian there, anything's possible in the passing game.
It felt like maybe at the beginning of the season, the first four games, you kind of lean on the offense to put up enough points to win the game. Mm-hmm. Now it seems like that relationship is more we need each other with the defense. Yeah. Has that changed at all?
No, I mean, you're absolutely right. In the past few years, I guess it's been, let's see which team steps up. Is it the defensive team or the offensive team? Which team is going to step up? And I think this year we're battling for each other, and we're pulling for the defense, and we're excited for everything that they do. And, yeah, maybe the first couple of games it seemed like, you know, let's just score as many points as we can, hope we win. But now I think with the way the defense is playing and how fast they're playing, how hard they're playing, I think it's more of a team effort. You know, I get more and more excited when Jordan Prater gets an interception, or Kai Nakua gets an interception, or Sky gets an interception, just as much as one of our guys gets a touchdown on offense. So it is more of a team effort, and that's why, you know, we can win more games and be more confident when we're playing as a team.
I know that you're playing well coming off of a win, and it was a good performance against Middle Tennessee, but even in the first half when it was 7-0 or 7-7, I noticed that there was more passion. There was more celebration. It just seemed like the energy level was way better than the previous few games. How did you see that from your perspective?
No, I actually really did. I really, really did see it. In pregame, there was a lot more energy. I don't know necessarily where it came from, but it was from players for sure. They put some music on. There was a lot more noise, a lot more chaos in the locker room before the game. I remember
that's a good thing.
A good thing.
Chaos in the locker room.
Good thing. Right before the game, it's a good thing. And I remember Coach Menal having to come in, everyone having to yell at each other to be quiet and to settle down because we were so excited for the game. And that carried over. I mean, that was the beginning of the game, and came in tied. And I think that energy continued after halftime. And I mean, that's how we win games. It starts with the players and our motivation.
We've heard that the who's in charge of the music has rotated a bit depending on certain games, and we've heard some fun stories associated with that. Who is in charge of the music now?
I think it's our I think it's Zach Nyborg,
director of football operations.
I think it is, but I think he takes requests. Mm. So I don't know where it stems from. I've requested. I don't know. Mine hasn't been played yet, but it will be played.
Come on, Zach.
I'm sure it'll be 80-0 once we play my music. Just kidding. But.
Okay, what is your request, Mitch?
No, it's my friend's a DJ, and he made a song, so it's just like a. It is just a mashup of a few songs, but so it's a surprise. I can't reveal anything.
Okay,
gotta get the guys juiced.
Okay, what was played?
That game, I
to create the chaos.
I couldn't tell you. It was something that people could dance to, because I remember there was a lot of dancing going on before games. So
okay.
It wasn't techno, because you can't dance to that. It was hip hop. So guys were dancing and going crazy. There was even a couple of GAs that were dancing. Manasseh Tonga was in there dancing and going crazy.
Brandon Bradley had to be dancing.
That's right. I think he was in there.
Who's the best dancer on the team?
Oh, wow. Man, that is a good question. Let me think here.
Because we saw some good job, good efforts in the at Bronco's house preseason.
Those were hilarious, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, Jamal's a very good dancer. Let me see here. Besides myself, it has to be
naturally.
Jamal is a very good dancer. We have a lot of guys that can dance. I mean, and if you don't have the most fluid hips. I mean, there's guys trying, and that's all that matters.
You'd think the defensive backs would be the best at dancing if hips are the deal. Right? Yeah. It'd be those guys.
They should be. They
okay,
should
Mitch,
be.
We're going to deliver you some bye week karma so that the team can get healthy. BYU Sports Nation Thank karma you. Is real. We gave it to Jordan Leslie last week.
Touchdown.
Saw what he did. Got a touchdown. And we'd like you to sign our Rise Up flag
no doubt,
as well.
No doubt.
We've talked to you so much, and you haven't been in the studio. That's fantastic.
I'm excited to be here.
If you want to bring anything like Michael Elisa's face mask that we have here from you, we'd love to have it on set at some point in the future.
I'll bring some gloves.
A glove or something.
Okay. I'll bring some gloves.
Yeah. We're up.
I'll bring some triple X's for you.
Beggars can't be choosers, and we beg a lot.
Hey, Mitch, great to have you on set.
Yeah, thanks for having me, guys.